COVID-19 has created many lingering ailments for survivors. For some, it's distorting their sense of smell, making the most delicious meals unappetizing.
We've heard for months that having COVID can make you lose your sense of smell. Now, some people are reporting something even more bizarre. Their sense of taste is being warped. It's called parosmia, and thousands of people are sharing their experiences on social media. Imagine taking a sip of wine and it tastes like gasoline. That's what one woman reported. People afflicted with this often describe foods they've enjoyed before as smelling foul, fishy, or burning flesh. Doctors said before COVID, this type of ailment was rare, but now more common. How concerned should we be about this becoming a long-term effect?
Hey, Drew. Okay, here we go. This is really a common complaint. People are saying that their sense of taste is off, the smell is off. What's happening?
Well, you know, interesting with my ENT background that, you know, I'm following COVID from an ENT point of view. And think about it, Dr. Ian, that the virus enters our body through the nose and mouth. Well, what goes on in the nose? You have all those receptors and nerve endings that process the sense of smell. Mm-hmm. And in the mouth, you have taste buds that process the sense of taste. So if those things are affected by the virus, which is happening when it invades the body, we're going to have these strange changes in those senses. So you heard it's called parosmia, or a distorted sense of smell, and that's to be compared to anosmia, where you can't smell at all. We talk about it all the time. COVID-19 is a new bug. We didn't know anything about it. We didn't know the basic science and natural history. We're learning every day. I remember Dr. Fauci was on a couple times, and he said, we just don't know. We're learning every day. So this issue of changes in smell and taste, we didn't expect it. You do see it sometimes with the flu or a common cold. Mm-hmm. Typically, it does resolve on its own. Unfortunately, with COVID-19 cases, we're seeing these aberrations in smell and taste lasting a little bit longer. Now, what can you do about it? Well, I think the biggest thing is give it time and wait. It should self-correct over time. There is a place potentially for anti-inflammatories, maybe steroids will help. And then down the line, if this really is a major problem where you're, you know, smelling these horrible things like foul trash and mm-hmm. bad food and things like that, you may want to go through something called smell training.
Sure.
Where it, like physical therapy for your senses. You can also do it for taste by using certain common tastes and scents, eucalyptus, lemon oil, clove, things like that, that you can retrain your brain to process this stuff.
You know, Drew, I'm glad you said that. And I've been saying this, that what the public has to be patient with the medical community. We're learning all of this on the fly, and we're honest about it. Listen, there are things we know really, really well. We have a long history with understanding and treating and diagnosing. COVID-19 is so new to the scientific and medical community that things change, like, you know, and it can change week to week. And so people have to be patient and allow us to figure this out. So I'm glad you actually said that, because there's been a lot of grief saying that, well, one minute the CDC says this, then they say that. Well, because, you know, they're learning, we're learning together.
Things change, and it's so important for we doctors to understand that, and everybody out there that is dealing with this pandemic.